Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Addie. This here is little Rosemary. She is 11 weeks old and we have been filming the last 2 months or so different activities that we've been doing so that I could share some ideas on different ways to entertain your newborn. I guess I should preface this by saying you probably don't really need to entertain your newborn, but I'm a mom. I know sometimes you just feel like you want to do something. So these are some of the things that we have done to try to help her with development. And gosh, I can't believe she's almost 3 months old and we're out of the newborn stage almost. So I hope this video helps you get some good ideas for your little one. So the first thing I want to mention is just alone time. And we do our alone time in a bouncer, a play gym, a swing, you know, one of those things. And it is so important to give babies alone time because it gives them the chance to explore their environment at their own pace and not get overwhelmed. It helps them become self-reliant, focus their attention, and learn from their mistakes and stuff. And it's just so important. And if you want to give them something when they get a little bit older, they tend to be able to use their feet before their hands with any sort of coordination. So I like to give them stuff at their feet first. Next up is to just walk around your house and name objects for the baby. You can also like sit with them and name body parts for them or just narrate your day. But the more words they hear, the stronger the mental connections get. And that process can strengthen your child's future language skills and just their overall ability to even learn. And infants who get more baby talk and more words in, they know more words by age 2 than their peers do. So don't underestimate the importance of talking to your babies. Next up is to play with some silk scarves and give them a little bit of a sensory experience, as well as if you put it over their like head, it'll give them a visual perception challenge and help them strengthen that as well. Next up is to use high contrast cards to look at with them. They're easy for them to see and it helps strengthen their eye muscles. And it's also great to use during tummy time to help them encourage looking up and getting their head strength up. And I will lead that into another activity is tummy time, which most babies don't love, but it is a really important exercise to do with them because it helps them build their strength that they need to meet their milestones like rolling and sitting and walking. Most people recommend 5 minutes a day, but they do not have to be consecutive 5 minutes. It can be a minute in the morning, a minute in the afternoon. And you can do it on the floor, you can do it on the boppy, you can do it in front of a mirror, you can do it on mom's chest, which is like my favorite way, lots of ways, but it is important to do tummy time, so that is a great activity as well. And since I mentioned mirrors, putting a mirror up for your little one to find themselves in is so super cute. And once they do find themselves and they lock eyes, it's just adorable. Next up is doing some stretching, letting them doing it alone or guiding their arms and legs to show them more stretches. It helps them open their joints and muscles and can help them get things moving in the digestive area. It's just really good for babes. Like imagine being asleep and when you wake up, like good to stretch your own body out. So helping them do that and showing them different ways they can stretch is a good way to pass some time. Another idea for some sensory play and gross motor kind of skills is to help them try to roll from side to side. It's a skill that they're going to be trying to develop on their own. So it's just something that you can kind of help them with and just kind of get their body moving in the direction towards. This is good attachment and bonding for them as well. Next up is to get a toy or rattle or something for your baby to focus on and follow from side to side. It'll help them focus. Like that is actually a skill that babies need to learn to focus and also with their tracking skills. Another activity that my newborns have loved is laying under a tree. That high contrast with light and movement. Young babies just love that. And you can also do like set off a bubble machine or something. That's another like thing that they love looking at too is the bubbles flying by. It's so calming. And if you time it just before nap, you could even kind of take them on a walk right after this, continue looking at some trees and kill 2 birds with 1 stone and get them to fall asleep. If you have older kids, letting them play with the baby is another way to keep them entertained. I would do this supervised if I was you from personal experience. Another thing you can do with little ones is do bicycles or tummy massage. You want to do that in a clockwise motion.
But that will, one, do something to entertain them, but two, it will help their bellies and their digestive system get anything moving to avoid gas and backup. It's great bonding and it helps soothe them, and they don't know how to do that at a young age. So definitely doing those things that will soothe them is important. The last thing I will say today is just talking to your little ones. You know this already. This is nothing new, but talking to them, singing to them, touching them. It's so great for bonding and nurturing. They'll start smiling back at you around 6 to 8 weeks, which is so rewarding. Mine laughed for the first time 2 days ago, which was 11 weeks old for her. It's just like the best thing ever. And I'll also note that if when you are playing with them, if they start fussing, squirming, crying, they might need a break. They get overloaded in their senses so easily. So definitely pay attention to their cues.
Alrighty, that is all for today. I hope you got some good ideas for your little one, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.